Game Designers, and to find out more information, please introduce yourself.
My name is Philip Boutte Jr. I am an executive board member of the CDG Local 892, and I am a concept artist and a costume illustrator within the guild.
Ooh, okay, concept artist. Now I have a question for you. What are your thoughts on AI with your
language? Such a big question, like straight out the gate. You chose violence this morning. AI, to a degree, obviously I don't agree with it in terms of being able to, because it's going to replace a lot of jobs, or at least it's stepping into a place creatively that we don't need to be. I also think that the way that it was generated unethically, meaning it scraped a lot of the art from my specific group to train or to teach the AI, but it really just pulled our work without our permission in order to do it, which is interesting now because we're having, which I laugh about, people saying like, hey, your work looks like AI, and it's like, no, AI looks like my work, which, because it's trained to do that. So it's an interesting balance, but we'll see kind of where it goes.
Yeah, I agree. I get a lot of those questions too, because I'm an artist, and a lot of people think, oh, is that AI? I'm like, no, it's not AI.
Yeah, it's not AI.
Yeah, very cool. What advice could you give to someone who's aspiring to be a costume, concept artist and costume designer?
I think the main thing, you have to love it. First off, you have to love the actual job. There's a job here. And I think that that's something that speaks to costume design in general, is the way that I've enjoyed costume design and interacting with it is the fact that there's a lot of research, education, learning, studying, but there's also a functional job of creativity. The spark of the character, the first glance at what a character could be, starts with the costume designer, the actor, concept artist, or the costume illustrator, kind of figuring out what that's going to look like and kind of spitting it back out. And I think the job, the fluff on top of costume design is like, you know, the fancy party, the, you know, notoriety, all of those things. That's not the actual job. The job is someone being able to look at a character on the page and say, this woman is jealous, so I'm going to dress her in a green pantsuit, and I'm going to do this, and I'm going to put a collar on her. Like, all of those details, the thought process from that, from nothing to something, that's costume design. Or talking to a costume designer like Michael Kaplan. And, you know, I illustrate what he says. So he says, I want to draw Spock, you know, for Star Trek, and I want to put him in this. I illustrate it. It goes to the thing. But costume design is Michael knowing to put the shoulder seams back to make, or forward, to make Leonard Nimoy, who was, you know, older, make him look like he's standing up straight, right? Like, that's costume design. There's so many elements to it. So I think that if you want to get into this field, you really have to do your research and know your stuff, and also really love it, because it's not going to be easy.
Ooh, hear that? Well, thank you very much for sharing those gems.
I have one ad lib. I saw the YouTube video, I guess, from the Costume Designers Guild about how you got into the business at the Comic-Con. So can you ask him about how you got discovered?
Okay. Oh, yeah. So how did you get discovered with Comic-Con?
I went to Comic-Con when I graduated, I'm going to date myself, 2006, spring of 2006. And there was a panel of costume designers speaking about costume design, and I think the two that I remember, it was Juliana Makowski and Isis Musenden, right? So they're on this panel. It was me and a few friends who actually were here, some of them, Oksana and Brian, and we just went down the line and showed our portfolio based on the fact that we had a teacher, Robin Richardson, who is a costume illustrator, and she's also in Local 800 as a storyboard artist, right? So she had told us about it, but we didn't know anything about it. So we go down the line and we're just showing our portfolios, didn't think anything of it. A week later, Oksana, my friend Oksana, she got a call from Isis and said, hey, how would you like to go to Prague with me for 9 months to do Narnia 2? Which is like, this is a month after we've graduated college. Like, when you're like, what am I going to do for work, right? So she goes to go do Narnia. I was a production designer at the time, so I was designing sets and music videos and stuff like that. I continue to work, and at the end of that year, I decided I'm going to join the Costume Designers Guild. So I joined the guild, and a month later, I got hired by Sonya Hayes to do The Mummy 3 with Jet Li, Michelle Yeoh, and Brendan Fraser. And so that was my first job, and then it just randomly, just from there, I've been doing it ever since.
Oh, wow.
Comic-Con, okay.
At Comic-Con.
Comic-Con. So go to Comic-Con.
I would say go to Comic-Con.
Bring your resume. Bring your portfolio.
Be prepared. Be prepared wherever you are. I remember I dressed up in a suit and I had a briefcase and I went to my... See, she knows. Like, complete nerd. I had a whole thing and I had books on ancient China and I showed my stuff in my portfolio and Sonia looked at me and she said, I love that you came with ideas. They're all wrong, but I'm going to hire you. And that was my first job. So.
Wow, what a great criticism. Well, thank you so much for sharing with us.
Thank you very much.
Nice to meet you.
Very nice to meet you. Thank you. Thank you guys very much.
Okay, thanks. Yeah. Can you stand because we can't shut the door, yes. Unfortunately. Just okay, next. Okay.
Hi. Hey everyone, my name is Rena Tolentino. We are here at the UCLA School of Business, and I'm here with a costume designer.
My name is Mandy Line. I'm a costume designer. I've been doing this for about 26 years. You might know me from Pretty Little Liars, or The Bold Type, or now that this music's coming back in, I'm going to drop it. Korn, System of a Down, 30 Seconds to Mars, Alien Ant Farm. I could go on and on about the sick new world tour that's now come back. And started their careers with them and was with Linkin Park for 5 years.
Oh my gosh! Linkin Park!
Cool back in the day.
So when I was little, I'm gonna say how old I am. But
younger than me, so you're good.
We're probably the same age. Okay. My female friends used to dress up as Fred Durst.
Well, he's
I'm
a singer.
Sorry.
I actually dress Limp Bizkit too, so
I'm
that's
sorry.
Okay. That's okay. Did you do a tank top and like jiggies?
Yeah, they wore the hat backward.
That's
fine.
They're actually all the same.
I
got to be honest. Like,
okay. I have a question. Yeah. What do you think about AI in your field?
Well, I am going to take credit for being a Leo and having that ego and finding like the hottest picture of me online and AI, I'm like, oh my God, this is great. This is amazing.
Yeah.
And then hearing the feedback and not being educated enough on what that meant. I mean, don't get it twisted. Those pictures were fun.
Yeah.
But what it did to friends and artists like Philip and up and coming ones, like if that's starting here, what's happening with my career? What's happening with actors? I mean, it's just... It's a trickle-down theory or trickle-up theory. It's going to hit us all if we don't make a stance.
Yeah.
You know, same with pay equity. If we don't have a voice, and if 26 years of doing this doesn't give me a voice by now, and if I don't use it, then what am I doing here right now? It is more than just costumes. And we all say that, and we all know that.
Thank you for sharing that.
You're welcome.
I love
cool.
your
Thanks
energy. Wait, I'm not
talking. And this is after a concert. Last night.
Wait, okay, so tell us about your outfit.
Right? So, travel a lot for my work. We get called to go, I mean, have people in this room, we get called to go different states, different countries all the time. And I try to pack really small. That never works.
Do you fold your clothes or do you roll your clothes like I do?
I try, and then it's just like effortless. So I was like, okay, this is like 20 bags. But a lot of us wear jumpsuits now because at the end of the day, we're working 17 hours. We want to put something on, still look cute. So why not like represent your name and represent what we do?
Tracy's wearing a jumpsuit too.
Maybe
she's so cute.
Literally, we're like, we know each other longer than we've been in this business. Every time we see each other, leopard, jumpsuit.
Yeah.
So we don't even have to call anymore. We just know we're going to show up.
I love that.
The same, but so
twin
different.
Flames. I feel some twin flames energy.
Oh, yeah, it happens. We always have to, like, we always know. We kind of just know where we're
It's the yin to the yang.
It is. But watch out for that yin and yang, okay?
Ooh.
Watch out for us. You know what I'm saying? Us two walking in a room? Don't underestimate it.
Yes. I love it. Love your energy. What advice could you give to your 10-year-old self who wanted to do what you're doing now today?
Eat the cake, first of all. Being skinny doesn't matter that much. 10-year-old self. Well, when I was younger, I had a disability that caused me to hide who I was. Mm. And I hid through costumes. I made head wraps, I made scarves, I made wigs. And through that, the creativity was overflowing. So to my 10-year-old self and to anyone out there that maybe feels awkward, doesn't feel like part of the group, find who you are above all of that. You never know, you might end up here 26 years later. Mm-hmm. It's because of what I thought wasn't good enough about me.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. That's true. Yeah, so I always try to say, like, you don't, you know, if you feel you're the kid with this that's different or this that's awkward, show them up and be the girl that walks in the room, you know, and takes, you know, grabs all that energy because of the things that are your talent and the things that make you feel good.
Thank you. Thank you for sharing.